Hey, what's up, everybody? Gonna do a classic rock reaction, man. And this is an album reaction coming your way. And the album is called Angel's Eggs. And it's by a progressive rock band called Gong. Very, very interesting. I'm not quite sure. I'm pretty sure I haven't heard of Gong. I don't know. I'm thinking maybe Bang a Gong, but it's not the same thing. But yeah, looking forward to it, man. It's always interesting to discover buried treasures, so to speak. So it's going to be interesting to check these guys out. So first off, I just want to give a shout out and a thanks to Amy Brooks. Amy, thanks very much for the recommendation and introducing me to something new, man. So Amy says, hi, Wayne. I've got a recommendation for you. It's an album called Angel's Eggs by progressive rock band Gong. This album was recommended to me by this very cool guy I met in his record shop as I was browsing his collection, and it stayed with me ever since as far out listening adventure that takes me on a guaranteed wild trip with no need of any help, although that's always fun. It's such a cool album and band that aren't very well known outside of their very dedicated fan base. I hope you enjoy. Thanks and peace. Right on, Amy. Thank you. So, let's hit this up, man. Angel's Eggs. That's a long ass album too, man. It's almost an hour. Damn. 50 minutes. Alright. Let's go all the way through. Angel's Eggs by Gong. Let's get it. Other side of the sky. Cheers. It's going to be a cerebral attack, something like Pink Floyd.
sky, don't know why. And now this spaceship heading for me. I thought I was lost in the spaces, now all these faces. And still I can't tell if it's really a spell or exactly what's happening.
Is this a concept album of sorts?
It's a hassle, you know, to make rocket ships go to infinity. But I'm so sick of God and his bishops, the dog of divinity. Now my head's feeling strange and my country's starting to tremble. And the head in the sky there is starting to look like the devil. Look out!
It's interesting, back in the 70s, early 70s, how a lot of songs segue into each other. Kind of like Marvin Gaye's What's Going On, you know.
Thank you.
was a trip. I imagine this whole album is meant to be that way.
Was that? Where is it?
Thank you.
Sexy sense.
That was a nice piece there.
Yes,
Now, if you want to know just how to tune into the vibes of the planet, nobody else can tell you, everybody got their own way to do it. Papa Zoom Zoom, I have a hubba dubba boom, sticky stacker. Papa Zoom Zoom, I got a hubba dubba boom, sticky stacker.
About the left wing, you It's getting very strange. Maybe we're just deranged. I'll tell you something's gonna change. You change your car for another. Change your telly for a color. You change your bird for your mother. Nothing is for nothing is for.
Chew with lots of style. All right. Wow. So that is Angel's Eggs, the album by Gong. Very, very interesting. Good musicianship. My mind literally shut itself off after a period of time where it comes to lyrics and stuff like that. Sometimes you've got to do that. Like, I'm going back to my yes reactions after a while. My brain just shut itself off from trying to make sense of the lyrics, right? And you realize that this is more so an experience in sound. This album is like that too. It's like a tossed salad of sound, you know? And of course they've got some things to express and some things that are relatable, but overall with the mix of everything, it's like from every single direction there is sound to analyze. And I think that this album was meant solely for the experience of tripping out, the experience of and they were probably visualizing their audience, in a live atmosphere where they're just together, hanging out, dancing, shaking, smoking, doing all of that stuff, or at home, just chilling out at a party or whatever. This is the music that will be playing in the background and people will be jamming, jiving, getting high to it. That was its intention. And that's definitely the mood and the feel that I get from it. It's really good though. It's very different, but really good. So, let's get to know these dudes, man. If you guys were one of those lucky ones who heard this album when it first came out, tell me about it. What were you doing? What did you think? How were you feeling? Were you and your friends digging it? Did it take a couple of listens until you got into it? Were you smoking? Were you high? What was happening in the atmosphere around you? Let me know. Some of you old cats, damn, this is like 73. Holy shit. So, let me know about that. Let's do a little background here. First on the band and then the album. So, Gong. Gong are a progressive rock band that incorporates elements of jazz and space rock into their musical style. The group was formed in Paris in 67 by Australian musician David Allen and English vocalist Gilly Smith. Band members have included Didier Malherbe, Pip Pyle, Steve Hillage, Mike Hallett, Pierre Morlin, Bill Laswell, and Theo Travis. Others who have played on stage with Gong include Don Cherry, Chris Cutler, Bill Bruford, Brian Davison, Dave Stewart, and Tatsuya Ishida. Bill Bruford. Tell me why that's so familiar. Gong's 1970 debut album, Magic Brother, featured a psychedelic pop sound. By the following year, the second album, Camembert Electric, featured the more psychedelic rock space sound with which they would be most associated. Between 73 and 74, Gong released their best-known work, the allegorical radio known Invisible Trilogy, describing the adventures of Zero the Hero, the Good Witch Yanni, and the Pothead Pixies from the planet Gong. Yeah, I think they've used that term Pothead Pixies maybe two times in this album. In 75, Allen and Smythe left the band, which continued without them, releasing a series of jazz rock albums under the leadership of drummer Pierre Merlin. This incarnation soon became known as Pierre Morlin's Gong. Meanwhile, Smythe formed Mother Gong, while Allen initiated a series of spin-off groups, including Planet Gong, New York Gong, and Gong Mason, before returning to lead Gong once again in 1990 until his death in 2015. Rest in peace to you, sir. With Allen's encouragement, the band decided to continue releasing the album Rejoice, I'm Dead in September of 2016, and The Universe Also Collapses in 2019. Okay, so that's a brief outlook of the band. So, Angel Eyes, or Angel's Eggs, the album. Angel's Eggs is the fourth studio album by progressive rock band Gong, released on Virgin Records in December of 73. It was recorded using the Manor Mobile Studio at Gong's Humeul home, Pavilion de Hay Fossos in France, and mixed at the Manor Oxfordshire in England. The album was produced by the Gong under the direction of Giorgio Gomelski. Angel's Eggs is the second in Gong's Radio Gnome Invisible trilogy of albums, following Flying Teapot and preceding You. The trilogy forms a central part of the Gong mythology. The original album did not have an apostrophe in the title. Yeah, so it is a concept album of sorts, running in a series format. The original vinyl edition came with a booklet containing an extensive explanation of the mythology, including lyrics, a glossary of terms, and profiles of characters in the story and band members. Okay. Yeah, there's context for you. So, we're missing the booklet containing the explanation of the mythology and all that. So, it would be a lot easier to follow concept-wise and all of that stuff. So, that's why I couldn't really follow everything where it comes to lyrical content. This edition also had a gatefold cover, omitted in later pressings, a plain inky blue inner sleeve to match the gatefold and booklet, and had the original black and white Virgin label, which was discontinued after 73. It was one of the last albums to use the original label. Some copies had a sticker over top of the female nude in the moon on the cover. The CD version, released by Virgin Records and later reissued on Charlie Records, contains an extra track, Ooby Scooby Doomsday, or the D-Day DJs Got the DDT Blues. that ends with a male voice choir glissando, questionably regarded by some by whom as a parody on Pink Floyd's Echoes, starting with ah and ending with chew, mimicking a sneeze. Right. The track was originally released on the Live Etc. album, but was excluded from the CD release, which reissued that double album as one disc and included on this album instead. Okay. That's album information and background. There is a Angels album review here by David Ross Smith of AllMusic. And he says, quote, "The companion piece to the Flying Teapot, Angel's Egg, is not your usual progressive rock album. Very quirky, with many mostly brief compositions, the album is a tad less spaced than Teapot, with just a few psychedelic-inspired lyrics, and it's very technically adept. Angel's Egg opens with a true space rock cut, one of the few on the album, filled with the usual Gilly Smith or Smythe space whispering and David Allen voicings, then leads into the cleverly tilted Sold to the Highest Buddha with Steve Hillage and Didier Malherbe prominent figures. The instrumental Castle in the Clouds finds Hillage coming into his own with a sound identical to his solo work. Given My Love to You sounds like a bar song with no music and a cluster of seeming drunken fellas trying to sing." That was cool though. "The instrumental Flute Salad gives way to Oily Way, a showcase for Malherbe's jazzy flute." That was nice. Good jam in it. "Inner Temple, an instrumental space rock track, moves along with a jazz edge provided by Malherbe sax. The final three tracks are the real highlights on Angel's Egg. I Never Glid Before is a fantastic progressive rock tune, replete with blistering Hillage solo, Primo Allen lyrics and vocal, and the precise percussion of new band member Pierre Merlin. This eclectic composition travels through several movements and time changes and comes across as a perpetually progressing piece. The imaginative and jazzy Eat That Phone Book Coda brings the album to a close." Yeah, like I said, man, it's a tossed salad of sound and all kinds of things going on in your head. It's just meant to be an album to trip out to, and they certainly accomplished that. It'd be really interesting to put all three pieces together and just play that shit in the background of a party or something like that. And I'm sure back in the day, a lot of you have. Let me know if you've done that. All right, very interesting. Really, really interesting, Amy. Way out there, man, let me tell you. But really good. I like the musicianship. They're excellent musicians. Good vocalizing, and they got a lot going on for them. And like I said, there were some passages in there that just kind of made me think of a Frank Zappa style. And the only thing missing was his... Is it a baritone voice that he's got? Bass baritone voice? And... then his really, really cool guitar soloing. Frank Zappa guitaring is one of the nicest sounding guitar soloing I've heard. You know what I'm saying? So he's really got a certain way about him. And I kind of got those vibes in certain areas here. Let me know if you think about what you think about that, or if I'm way out like this album is. All right. Amy, thank you very much. I appreciate this. This was great. Thanks for introducing me to something new. If you have heard this before, let me know what you think about it. I bet you it's been more than a minute since you've heard this shit, or you might have forgotten about it. Or if it's your first time hearing it, let me know what you think about it. For me, it's definitely going to take a few more listens. And I think it's intended for you to listen, not in a concentrated form like me sitting here listening, but kind of like I'm picturing the background, party gathering, or just chilling, going about doing your thing, doing something, you know. But I think that's how it's meant to be. It's just meant for you to be tripping to, you know. That's the way I put it. All right, so coming up, Svein, Evelyn, Pete, got reactions I've got to hit up for you. And that's going to be coming up in the next couple of days, man. So you guys have yourselves a good one. Hope you like this. Take care, and I'll see you tomorrow. Peace.